Chapter 8. Welcome to Appaloosa.
Act natural,
Bon Bon whispered as they disembarked onto the dusty wooden train platform.
Blend in while we get an idea of what's occurring in this place. Look for suspicious activity. Don't talk to any pony, okay?
Lyra nodded her mint mane and followed Bon Bon through the dusty terrain into the center of the western town. The main street was lined with businesses on both sides, including a charming saloon called the Salt Block, and a town hall. Sure enough, ponies dressed just like them, in cow pony hats, dresses, and fringe, trotted to and fro across the street.
No pony has noticed us, Bon Bon,
Lyra whispered, enchanted with everything about our current situation.
We're blending in!
Hound there!
The gold stallion immediately called out.
We're not,
said Bon Bon, shooting Lyra an angry look.
You're new here, and I'm Braybird,
the stallion said as he trotted over. He wore a brown vest and cowpony hat, which looked great with his huge smile.
Welcome to beautiful Appaloosa!
He kicked his forelegs up in the air.
What brings you fine pony folk here to our fair town?
The piece of hay in his mouth bobbed up and down as he spoke.
I'm Sweetie, and this here is Artstrikes,
Bon Bon said, curtsying in her green dress. She didn't miss a beat.
We're apple sales ponies from a little town near Dodge Junction, and we're looking for a new supplier.
Yeehaw!
We heard that you got a great farmer in town here. Mr. Apple Crispy?
Lyra added with a drawl that sounded quite forced.
Aw, diggity!
That's right, miss. Braeburn gave Lyra a funny look.
Appaloosa is indeed home to our famous farmer Apple Crispy. I gotta introduce you. Well, he's a little, under the weather right now.
Braeburn's eyes darted around. He was definitely hiding something.
Can I interest you fillies in some delicious local Appaloosa and applesauce at the Salt Block?
Bon Bon and Lyra exchanged a look. The more time they spent in Braeburn's presence, the more clues he would have about them to piece together.
I don't know. We best get into our barn and breakfast to check in,
Bon Bon said, even though Lyra was positive they had not made a reservation anywhere.
Beat the rush! Is that what's got your fringe in a twist?
Braeburn playfully nudged Bon Bon.
Why, you got none to worry about there,
Braeburn smiled.
We don't get many visitors down here in Appaloosa as is. Not since the rodeo ended anyway.
Lyra perked up.
Is that so?
Sadly, yes. Braeburn's shoulders slumped. Why, the last visitor we've had round was Granny Honeycomb's cousin, old Delilah. And she's been staying at the barn breakfast so long, she's starting to feel like family.
And how long does that take?
Asked Bon Bon.
A few weeks or so.
Braeburn chuckled.
So you're next,
he motioned down the road.
Say, there's Delilah now.
For an old mare, she was exceptionally stunning.
Oh my.
Delilah had a beautiful gold and silver mane.
Elsa's pretty.
The sky blue hide, and a cutie mark of a gold heart-shaped apple. She wore a gold Appaloosa dress that shimmered in the sunlight. Lyra and Bon Bon were transfixed.
Oh, you lesbian horses.
Never before had they seen such a composed, exquisite mare. They watched as old Delilah trotted along, stopping ponies as she passed and greeted them with warm words. Each time she moved onto another group, the ponies looked like they might faint with awe.
Wow!
Breathed Bon Bon.
What a mare!
She is something,
Braeburn agreed, admiring her. He turned back to his new friends.
Now, how about that applesauce?
Sure, why not?
Lyra sprang forward, taking the lead. Bon Bon looked shocked. Lyra wasn't following the plan. They were supposed to remain as anonymous as possible, per the smile code. Not go around chatting to some pony to ponies in saloons, chomping on applesauce.
Say, I'll catch up with you ponies in a tick,
Bon Bon said. She stifled a very fake yawn.
I'm plumb knackered.
Suit yourself. Lyra shrugged and trotted off toward the salt block with Brayburn. Bon Bon was baffled. Clearly her best friend had an idea, but Bon Bon could not see how applesauce related to locating a changeling. It was beginning to look like Bon Bon would have to figure out this puzzle on her own.